Hello, welcome back to Retail Outsource. My name is Seb and today I'm going to show you how to use Pro Trader Lite on your eBay account. So as you can see from my screen, there's a tab called Pro Trader Lite New. So this is, if you want this one, the first thing that you have to do is to install an add-on. So that's called Pro Trader Lite. And this is part of an Optiseller. And then you have to sign in with your eBay. So to link the account. So this is kind of an eBay approved third-party system to optimize the listings. Okay. And this tool, this add-on, if you have this add-on, the main thing that you can do is to rate your current listing. So it will give you a score. It's called OptiScore. And it will highlight certain points that you can work on for those listing. And the second thing is that it will show you the aged inventory. So you can delete it and relist it, and you can download the reports and all those kind of stuff. But today, before doing, you know, relisting, deleting and everything, you know, you have to fix your listings first. You know, any issues like, you know, the score need to be above 7.5, okay? That's the target you have to achieve. So you can see from the screen, you know, once you have installed everything, you can see there's a column called Opti Rating, and it will start showing you a score. It will give you a score for your current listing. You can see it's on green, so that's it. It's good, actually. And it says good. And you can see average 7.3. So this is something that we have to fix it. So we'll just show you an example. So for this one, so Magic 2. Power line, and it says okay, 6.9. What you can do, you can click on show, so that will highlight the areas that you have to improve. Okay, the first thing is images. Basically, yeah, we have you know, you need to have at least 7 image. So that's something we have to add on later on to this listing. And the second is the title. So this is something we can do straight away. And for this one, there is an AI assist. Okay, this will work if you have you know, your item specific area filled properly. So the AI will have enough information to create your title. If you don't have item specific filled up properly, then the system will not work correctly. Anyways, I will just run it to show you. And before that, you can see it will come up with some suggestions, different variations of your title. And it will score that title as well. You can see that this title, it's 8.2, 8.1, 8.1. So ideally, I want to select this one. Okay, it doesn't come with 8.3. Okay, so I'm just going to go with the and select. Okay, I'm going to select the 8.2 and I'm going to click apply. So that will apply that. That's going to refresh the page. Okay, this is the listing that we were working on. So the score have gone up. It's 7.8. And if you go again, the pricing. So there is some suggestions for pricing. So we can click on the settings. And it says, okay, the price is on medium, on par with the market value. Okay, and it's suggesting that the lowest price is 28.85 and the highest is 63. So I would say 59. You know, don't take these figures from here. You have to check from your side as well. When I say you know, from my side, we can click on research price here. There is an option for that. So it will populate with the images, the titles, so you have more details. You know, what, who is selling at 28.39? You know, that's like half the price of what this listing is, right? So we want to make sure that if it's the same item or not. So you can see, you know, these are private sellers. Maybe they are clearing the stock or something, but you can get an idea on, you know, if your pricing is on par with the market pricing. And from my experience, if you get the pricing wrong, it doesn't matter if it's eBay, Amazon, or Etsy. If you get your pricing wrong, that means your pricing is, you know, higher, doesn't match up with the market, you know, for the similar product. Or if your pricing is too low, it will not work as well. So you have to have somewhere in the middle. We call it sweet pricing, sweet spot pricing. So your pricing need to be in between those levels. Okay, so that's pricing. If you want to change it, that you can change it. And that's about it. So you can keep on doing it. All the listing with the low scores, you have to go and check it individually and fix it. And then you can go to click on this tab, and that will populate the aged inventory as well. It will show you the, you know, how long it's been there and how many items are sold. You know, some of the items you haven't sold, then you have to think to delete those listing and relist it again. But before doing that, make sure that the listing is optimized and it have a good score. Okay. Yeah, that's just an overview of the Pro Trader Lite. Please let me know if you have any questions. I will be making more videos on this Pro Trader Lite as well. So please keep an eye on our channel. Thanks a lot for watching.